So for this chicken and rice dish, or the skum ga, which I had in Vietnam, you first need to trim off all the excess fat from everywhere. So I have always noticed that the tail has a lot of fat and the neck area also has a lot of fat. So just trim it off with a pair of scissors and then just give it a good salt massage. And then after the salt, of course, you need some good amount of pepper. Good amount of carrots. The red carrots are in season, so get those red carrots, cut them in big chunks and put it on the sheet, with the chicken. Now add some cloves of garlic. Put lemongrass in a nice neat bundle which I am stuffing inside the chicken, and along with it comes spring onions. Again, one majorly amazing Southeast Asian flavor. So after this, all you need is some good sprinkling of salt and pepper once again. Then I'm gonna add some recently boiled water. Now this is for curing the skin on top. It really adds a very nice silky texture to the breast. Now adjust the water to half the level of chicken and then put it in a preheated oven, which is at 200 degrees centigrade with the fan on, and keep it there for about 50 minutes. Every oven is different, so please adjust your temperature accordingly. Once the chicken comes out, if you poke a knife in the meatiest part, the juices that come out should be clear. It should not be bloody at all. Alternatively, if you have a meat thermometer, please get it to the right temperature, which is 90 degrees C. Then you got to take some rice. I took about 1.5 cups of rice. I washed it, cleaned it, and then put it to soak for about 30 minutes. I started heating a pan on medium to high heat. Once hot, I added a little bit of a touch of vegetable oil. Once the oil starts smoking in, I'm gonna add all the chicken fat that we had taken out of the bird before it went into the oven. Now I'm gonna render the fat off these pieces of chicken and get almost 1 to 2 tablespoons of fat in my pan. Once there, I'm gonna take those soaked rice kernels and I'm gonna fry it in that chicken oil. This is the best ever tip that I have taken from Vietnam or from any other country that I have ever visited. After this, I'm gonna add about 1/4 cup of wine. I'm gonna cook it till the alcohol is absorbed. And then I'm gonna add about 2 3/4 cups of water, enough to get the rice nice and fluffy. Give it a cover and let it cook on medium heat again till the time the water is all soaked up, which almost takes about 15 minutes. 10 to 15 minutes mark is when you need to come and check. Once there, you need to season the rice well with salt, pepper, and my favorite, those leaves, the onion leaves from the spring onion. You can use it here for seasoning. Now, twist comes into play. This is where I'm gonna make a white sauce to go along with my rice and my flavorful chicken. So all you do is make a basic white sauce. You start off with a touch of oil. After that, go in with equal amounts of butter, Then equal amount of maida or all-purpose flour. Fry it till the time you can smell the beautiful glutinous flour. You need to go in with some hand-pounded fresh garlic and fresh green chili. Give it a good stir in the buttery mix. Smell right now in your kitchen is going to completely tempt you. Start adding in some milk. Again, a tip. You must add cold, fridge cold milk into hot roux. Roux means the flour and butter mixture. Add the fridge cold milk because it will not coagulate into lump. Mix it well, take a whisk, give it a good whisk. You need to adjust the consistency to a place where it coats the back of the spoon. Switch off the fan and then add the juice. Not that it's gonna curdle anything, but I don't want the lemon juice to get cooked. Now, let's get to the plate. I put in a bed of rice over which I rest my chicken. I'm gonna pour in that hot sauce on top of the chicken to coat it completely. Garnish it again with some green onions, thinly sliced. And then all you got to do is dig in. Cheers! Everyone, today we are here to make prawns, olive oil and garlic. Oh, this is one amazing dish. This is traditionally served as a tapas in Spanish bar. I have personally taken this recipe from Mallorca, Spain. This is one of my travel memories. So let me share this simple recipe with all of you guys. So let's start. First thing to do is to chop your garlic. You don't have to be very precise in it, just a rough chop will do. Now you have to dump all your garlic in cold olive oil, and the olive oil and the garlic heats up together. Now once the oil is a little hot and everything starts to bubble up, then start putting in your washed and deveined prawns in it. Now you can use shrimp, prawns, tiger prawns, any kind of variety of any other kind of shellfish as well. Once you see your prawns turned nice and thin and you know it's cooked through, that is the time you add some salt in it. Okay? And squeeze some lime juice and mix it well. Switch off the flame and just sprinkle on some pepper. Your dish is ready, and all you need now is some really soft, freshly made pav. Dip that pav in that flavorful oil and just enjoy the prawns along with it. So, till the next time, cheers!